I'm not doing a speedrun, but the thing is, I can go over what's going to happen. It's basically Tia is very annoyed that you're not paying attention to her. That's all you have to fight monsters. That's I don't know how else to explain the level of this game, how this would be happening. This is just a tutorial dungeon to know how things work. And you move and it's fine. So, that's how that works. Jump to this room. Next one is basically you have an arrow, you can harm things, not harm things. Essentially, freeze them. I have a file on this one. Let me know how that is, if not I'll lower the video capture device again. To be fair, I'm not talking very loud anyway. The old man still makes the cross somehow. Also, I always wonder what. Oh, I'm gonna try something as well. Okay, I'll lower the game volume. Okay, there you go. What happens if I screw up? There you go. Oh wow, if you really mess up, he really tells you about it. Yeah, you gotta reset spell in case dungeon things go wrong. Okay, cool. I never actually messed that up before, so I was always curious actually what happened. That should be some lizards. Kills anyway. In some dungeons, you have to eliminate all the monsters. So, how's the audio now, David? And just send that to him, hidden switches. And then pauses. Oops. How's that one? It's weird actually using a Super Nintendo control again. And that's the dungeon. Well, should I lower or heighten it? Because I can't make the microphone louder. Still set to Yeah, it's still set to the microphone for... So I can still lower the volume. I reset the dungeon so this guy came back. And the other guy came back as well. It resets all the monsters too. She takes out the sink and this, I guess a big stock pot or something. The characters are really nice in this game. I have to just give them that. And someone stole a key. But yeah, I will be trying to get some of the boss rocks or whatever you want to call them. First attacks. Also, yeah, based on which way the enemy is facing, you can get preemptive strikes too, which can make a difference when you use the arrows and stuff like that. Let's go down here first. First strike here. I got the lizard from his tail. Passages. Like, this is a really good dungeon to teach you how things go. Yeah. There's gonna be two dungeons essentially by myself, then I get my second party member, and we'll go from there. How much gold? 65. Step down. The music in this game is great, for the record. I will heal in a second. Something about the menus in this game are just really satisfying too. Ah, yeah, so. Yeah, went the wrong way. It's control every now and then. Been too used to playing the Switch right now, so my thumb's kind of going where it shouldn't. Now they have 16 health. That's fine. Thank you. just bots. So it's really good if you get the first curing spell as well, but like, I think it takes 300 gold or something. Ridiculous. Oh yeah, right. You actually need to have the hookshot there. Fight you again. And it's all the enemies here. Ooh, I'm not doing obviously a speedrun of this, because that takes a step route, and I'm not learning a step route. Do I have to heal? I probably should heal. I actually had less, Oh well. I thought I had more HP than I did, but... Oh, that's why. Okay, yeah, so I should have killed him in two hits. I didn't, because this will do more than ball work, because that's critical. I was hitting the back attack, or back row monster. So. As you can see that they're on the same plane there. But, this match in case there's two of them. Let's buy them for some extra experience. I should have went back and grabbed some boomerangs. That wrecks the first boss really quickly. But, it won't be too difficult. It's just a matter of using potions. It's basically a whole attack to win for right now. Until a little bit later. Come on, bat. Blue bat. Okay, fine. Get you. Hey, you can see, this one's in the front row, the other one's in the back. So. I should be able to survive. That's. Yeah, I got 15 HP. Oh, okay. You can run too. That actually raises your attack power, I think. Strength is... Oh no, strength is a different stat. This game's great with its spell names and stat names. Not confusing at all. You should flee. Oh, wait. Alright. Let's experience them. When they're alone, they tend to run away. It actually hurts. Oh, okay. Help, MP, save over this file. I'm not gonna talk to you. So I don't have any abilities. I don't know what the IP actually stands for. Or CM. Charge meter? I don't know. It's like... Yeah, I never actually pay attention to that. There's CM and IP there, but either way, some items actually give you special abilities to use in battle, depending on that bottom bar, the orange one there. But, yeah, if you don't have, just gotta keep attacking and healing when need be. I moved in front of him, so... But when it fills up, you can use special abilities, and for the most part, first part of the game, you're not going to be able to do anything anyway. Heal again. Nah, I can attack one more time. But yeah, Sarah's right now in the living room playing Breath of the Wild. And I don't want spoilers for the shrines and stuff like that, so... I figured, hey, I'll bring this back here and stream for a bit, because that way she gets to play Breath of the Wild, no, and I don't have to worry about having spoilers. There you go. gets the key to the door. But it's goofy that, yeah, so basically it's like something's going on. Something mysterious, but then a lady in red appears, because of course a lady in red appears. So yeah, there's like a red meteorite that streaked across the sky, and this was causing all the monsters to go enraged now, and things to happen. Also, I have to say, this is actually a prequel despite being a sequel. Lufia 1 takes place after this, technically. This is technically a prequel to the first game, which is a very weird thing, but this was ridiculously well done. And thankfully, I actually played this before Lufia 1. Yeah, if you use boomerangs, it does like fixed damage, and you can kill them in, I think, 2 or 3 hits. It's actually pretty cool. Like the only part of the speedrun I actually pay attention to. Dead. I don't think I actually have to go back and talk to Tia. I'm trying to think of what I can and can't do, but we'll see. I just love the fact your guy doesn't actually have, or Maxim, or Sean, whoever, doesn't actually have a house. Okay. Sometimes enemies will move with you, like I said before, but you hold down the R button, you can actually change direction without moving. If you hold up, down, left, or right on the D-pad, and swing your sword, you can act and move them accordingly, so you can actually get them to approach you for optimal battles for you. Which is what I did, is, you know, staying there. The second area. I still have this part of the dungeon to do anyway. I do want to make sure I get everything. And money. Need money. Despite that. Life potion's useful. Heal, not heals, sorry, increases your max HP, obviously. And again, strong enough where I can kill things when I hit. You'll see me doing that a lot. I really do like manipulating movements. Oh yeah, now I got critical. Alright, criticals all around. Okay, so. And that escapes dungeons, so you don't have to walk out. But I still will, because why not? It's not too difficult. But I did play this for, like I said, about 2.5 hours. Truthfully, about 4, when I was trying to stop myself. I was trying to get certain items, so it's taking me a while. But basically, okay, I'm fine. Either way. Okay, and I have to heal, because this is gonna hurt. So I attack the ones in front first. Absolutely difficult to this game for just coming out of the first area. It's like, oh hey, cool, this thing can, this one random battle might kill me. So But magic doesn't, or still does full damage in the back rows. I think certain weapons can as well, I'm not too sure on that. Earthquake. So, I got some money here. I don't want defense. So I got small shield. Sure, hide armor and do I want to do that? No, I know what I'll do. Should be a spell merchant at the top somewhere. Oh no, he's beside the church in this town. Yeah. So I want strong. Because strong is the basic cure spell. Yeah. Oh, the inn's down here. I kind of give you a warning about earthquakes. It's cute. So I should give some backstory now that to the second town already. This is a game that I grew up with and thoroughly enjoyed. It's one of the very few RPGs where you don't customize your characters, like other than just basic equipment. I actually like, because I always prefer actually having files which are different to other people's. So. Should be dead. Yep, 14, and these guys should have about 18 or something. And no trouble. Yep, before I do anything, actually. Oh. Okay. Kinda goofy. Here, buddy. So did beetle, then did frog, then evil. Which makes a difference, actually. That's right, baby frog, I should say. Should be two hits. Okay, three. Hey, there's a chopping board. And here's the eagle. Thank you, singular. Three hits to kill. Two hits. Cool. So we fought beetle, the frog, and eagle. So the puzzle was you kill them and you hit them in which order that you kill them in. The plaque all explains it. Oh, okay. I'm trying to get a certain weapon. It's the reason I didn't buy a weapon in town, actually, or any right now, is because you actually get a really good dagger, I think it is. Well, either way, it's called the Insect Crush, and it does excess damage and all bugs, and there's a ton of bugs in this dungeon, so. And there it is. keep it to the end of the game, because I don't like getting rid of one-of-kind items. It's kind of goofy, but... you know, it works. Really? Yeah, those are IP attacks there. I gotta do this first. I hate it being there. So yeah, I do have essentially increased attack now comparatively, because I think it's better than everything that you can buy in town anyway. And then against beetles and other insects, it does a crap ton of damage comparatively. I'm not doing the puzzle again, but I will get healed. So, this is a very short dungeon, in the grand scheme of things. But... I should be able to one-hit KO those. No? Okay, 25 or something. They die within 3-9 attacks, at least, I know that. Chopping board? Aw. So, go here. Their damage is really annoying. Thankfully, there's a healing spot right beside here. Or not healing, sorry, saving. And to regenerate. So I gotta find that item now, so this is gonna take a while, so grinding. This is the other reason why I didn't actually do too much beforehand. That hurts. It's also why the reason I wanted the strong spell. Because they have... I don't know what chance drop. I know a boss coming up later would be 6%. But... eh, they filled up about the same that I use it. -1. We're gonna sit here and try to get an Eagle Rock, which increases my attack power, and dive itself does 2x damage to the enemies. Thankfully those back attack one that use that. What I should do is I should actually finish the rest of the dungeon, but... actually, eh, I'll do this first. Either way, I'm gonna have to try to get an Eagle Rock, and this is the easiest place to get one. How much HP? 24? I'm good. And if they kill me, I go back just to where I saved, just inside anyway. I have enough to do... the double vomit? Oh, okay, there's only one of them here, so I'm... bomb attack. This bomb attack hits obviously the entire row. And you just go back upstairs and heal your MP if you want. The thing is, it kind of gets annoying. I don't like how rare certain drops are, but at the same time, I understand why. Because the gemstones in this game are ridiculously good. Actually, go back. But, you know, they are worth the effort you put into them, especially the catfish shul. Unfortunately, that one will take probably the longest-ish time. And then the last one I'm going to make sure I do get is going to be, what is it? I think it's the Camu jewel. for that for a while. I'll be more than happy to leave it as is for who knows how long, really. But Mr. Eagle, you guys kill you and go back and heal after. But I don't know. Like, I'm not one obviously for streaming RPGs. Like, I'm really happy just playing. But I do want to do like a playthrough of this game, though. Because it's definitely worth the attention that people do give it. I think this is HP. Yeah, red's HP. And dead, because Insect Crush. Down versus the. Is the battle? Yeah. And it's not gonna make a difference if I were to use two bomb things. I guess it would. Whatever. Saves a little bit more IP. Grinding. Dirty work. Old games had it a lot. But I want to do a playthrough. Yeah. I did have it being there. Sometimes there's a text glitch error, which I know I'm aware of, and it's, it makes it so you get the item, but it doesn't actually appear. Also, like I said before, your IP fills up faster when you're lower health. Almost getting to the point where actually you can kill these guys in a hit with that. I think they have 20 HP or something. Between, I know some RNG involved. Oh, really? You have 1 HP left, buddy? Okay. That's cool. I know there's some RNG, but I also know that it's like, it's dependent on how the battles go. There's some weird step route that you can do, and like for the actual speedrun of the game. Because they get on the first fight. See how the IP went up higher that one. Yeah, the spawn point here is really useful. And yeah, I don't know how many times. Like, this is like the first big item of the game that you kind of can get, so I understand why. But you can see how much experience and money you get here, though. And with this money, I do actually do something actually useful. So, besides, dive is useful for a very long time. 1 HP left. Good job, buddy. Well, I think I'd grind here a little bit more differently than you, though. Because I know this is killing them or whatever, but actually, technically, to be fair, this should be easier here. Yeah. So I can get away with one bomb attack then. Actually, I'll just 25. Wonderful. Because no matter, he can't kill me. I'll get rid of him, and we're good and have full IP. Whoopsie doe. Or we're gonna fight him one more time. Hi, buddy. If I remember correctly, actually, they sell for... I want to say 1,000 or something? Like, it's not overly high amount, but it's a really good amount still. Especially for the beginning part of the game. But honestly, by the time you're grinding them anyway, you have tons of money. 1 HP each, really? Or sorry, not 1 HP each, 1 HP, but 4. I think, for the most part, I memorized all the monsters in this game. So. Making their movements and how much HP they have. Back when I was a kid. Get leveled before healing. Why do I have? Alright. See, what annoys me though about trying to get these rocks here, it does annoy me because you do get over leveled a little bit, but I skip fights later to kind of balance it out again after the bosses. I got 20. Cure this guy first for no reason. But yeah, the main thing I'm doing right now is just I want to get this Eagle Rock. I've gotten it a lot quicker than this before, but hey, it's how this game goes. Unfortunate, but that's how it goes. Okay. Let's fight just about a little bit. I just had to check as well in case I somehow miss seeing it pop up. So that's like what last thing I want to do is like, oh, it's like, no, I need one of them. Nah. No one hit KO. Also, I should say that controls-wise, you can use a D-pad and only the L button if you want. Like, you can obviously use a D-pad, but L button can be the actual input. So, it works quite well. Okay, I KO. And one hit KO. Okay. Ah, buddy, come on. This is actually quite slow comparatively to. Maybe I should actually learn the speedrunning route. Just for the first part, so I can actually get the. Nah, I don't wanna. Like, props to people who can run this game and really do step routes, but oh god. That'd drive me nuts trying to learn a step route. Especially since it's obviously based on RNG. Yeah, you can see how the healing is getting less and less, obviously. Really? Okay. It will come up with. It looks like a. Traditional, like, kind of power stone ish looking thing, and it says Eagle Rock when you get it. It'll be one line beneath the gold. And if there's a text glitch error, it'll have that line empty, but you'll still get the item. So, I'm looking for either Sean's experience points to be one line lower than normal, or I'm looking for the Eagle Rock thing. So, each one's a possibility. knows, maybe tomorrow I'll stream with Sarah for Snipper Clips because that's a good little game. Got a lot of fun playing it yesterday. Come on, you stupid eagles. I could have won the back row to more damage there. That could be. More battle than actually go do the rest of the dungeon quickly and then come back to this guy. Because it's getting annoyingly long to try to get an Eagle Rock. Like, it really shouldn't take this long. I don't think it's that high of a chance, or sorry, low of a chance of dropping. But, you know, I might be wrong. Oh yeah, this one. High enough level to one hit KO a lot of the stuff here anyway. Oh yeah, the L button's also with how do you also use your weapon or Y. As I smash the spider in her face there. Oh, so miss maybe contributed to how much defense you have as well. There either. Got a potion. Something. Two reasons. One, I want to see actually the amount I do heal for. Is important, so I know kind of if I'm fighting a boss and he does 20 or something, what if it's worth healing or, you know, using potions or high potions or whatever. Chopping board, yay! That's the death. Yeah, the catfish jewel. No, so I'm gonna be at least one more. Oh yeah, this I should have got this a while ago anyway. But... so speedy ring. Yeah, increases your defensive power plus agility, so it's worth it. And then here. There's a bunch of small things in this game I love. You see the second treasure chest behind it, and you have to find the hidden entrance there. And I think miracles, well, they do everything. They cure you completely and revive you, full HP, full MP, etc., etc. But they actually have no selling power. I think they only sell for one. Stairs there. Make the arrow point up. But I think there's only two puzzles in the game which actually give me some time to think. I gotta get this anyway. That's not a necessity. Rock there either. Go back up and get my MP back soon. Nope. And I remember like once or twice long, like a long time ago. Actually, I got it on like the first fights, like first within three. You're like, oh, okay. And you verse the catfish boss, you get wrecked. It's like a kind of a trade off. Heal again here. Probably get a chopping board from this match too. I'm purposely fighting as well, because I want to get a lot of money on this, because, well, I'm cheap in games, ironically, and to be cheap in games, you have to have a lot of money. MP, HP, okay, frog battle, sure, why not? I love when frogs and mosquitoes cooperate in nature. So weird. Nope. Ooh, we'll get rid of this guy too while we're at it. Yeah, not going that way anyway. Well, that's the last one. See, the thing is, it's not worth solving the puzzle above there as well, because every time you exit the room, it changes, or changes back, so. Which is super annoying, because when I want to try to grind the catfish jewel, I'll have to do that puzzle each time. Hopefully I'll get it soon. Well, the Eagle Rock and then the catfish jewel. It's the most grindy part of the game for me. And I want to say I purposely let him hit me, but whatever. Come on, give me a damn Eagle Rock already. Watch me, really. Huh? Two more of it sets two, and I'll get another level at least. Each one's 30-30, and if you have two characters, I think it goes down to 15. That's not that bad, actually, because I don't have to heal. Yeah, or sorry, heal during battle. Let's see if I can snip these into like hour-long ones. Meet Eagle Rock. So at this point, I'm a little bit too overleveled for my liking. This shouldn't take this long. But, hey. It's the game. So if you hold L, it automatically attacks. So if I push A, then A, or if I push or hold L, just immediately does it. If you there you go, Eagle Rock. Actually, really good now. A little bit high of a level, but whatever. One. Again, I did watch a little bit of the speedrun, so I did see kind of what's the fastest way to do certain puzzles. But I was just mostly just checking to see if it would be interesting for me to speedrun. And the answer is probably no. I did save it, right? Yeah, I did. Because this guy also has a gem, but I don't think it's as hard to get. Actually, So what I want to do is use dive, but I can't yet. Stuck. I think he has like 200 HP or something. I'm not too sure. 250. Like, he's quite the easy fight. Catfish, Lufia, 2. Oh, big catfish. I'm sorry, it's not registering on Google. I have enough? Cool, I got dive. Cool. How about you don't do that again, please? Yeah, so my strong spell technically heals more right now. That's what's running, because potions are fixed amounts, obviously. Nope. Let's get used to that screen for a second. Giant catfish. Well, it took me 43 minutes to grind out an eagle. Oh, okay, let's fight you. Hi. A second Eagle Rock. That would have been really nice, because eventually you get another character, and he gets definitely heavily into the physical attack power. But I was just playing this game a little bit beforehand, because of Come on, is there no... Is 12.5%, okay, that's what I was looking for. So, like I said, I'm pretty sure he has an okay amount of health. That hurts, though. That's good, though, because that gives me a lot of IP. I don't know what IP stands for. I never have figured that out. Like independent power? Inner power? Like, there's a lot of weird options. Just never bothered to check it out. That's confusing, because I was at CM there for some reason as well. So, yeah, whatever that means. Yeah, a level 11 here is way too high of a level. Oh, hey, cool, second try. I'll take that. I definitely will take that. That's basically getting a shiny. No, not shiny, sorry. I'm definitely not getting a shiny Pokemon. Let's reset here because I technically can't return. I will fight you for old time's sake. Hey, I will definitely take that. That'll make this actually a nice playthrough now. Because as of now, everything's going to speed up except for Camu, but everything else after that will be doing good. Cool, we're going to say hi to him again. Isn't that right, buddy? Hi. Die. There you go. No Eagle Rock. That's over. Okay. For some reason, I tend to hit that. Oh, okay, well that's confusing as hell for us then. But hey, you know, whatever. So, Akari points. Cool, thanks. But as of now, the playthrough will get fast again. Because I'm gonna have to kind of skip battles to kind of even up my level again, because I don't like being really overpowered in games. So, she doesn't change her dialogue if you don't see her. I don't know why she's doing here. Like, she doesn't give an explanation on that one. But basically saying, yeah, I'm going, and she'll force her way with you, basically. I know it's dangerous to do that, so she runs off. winning. They're not supposed to be. Oh, okay, he has 30 HP, so he barely survived that. There you go. T is a nice name. Now, give her the catfish jewel, which makes her magic resistance and whatnot go up quite a bit, but she becomes very, very strong all of a sudden. Now give her a small knife instead of a frying pan. I'll do shopping in the next town anyway. I don't know if we can get Flash yet, though. No. Oh, thanks for that, host Dave. I assume you're done streaming yourself, then? Ooh, wow. 6 HP. So damaging. Another chopping board before we go. For some reason, I really enjoy the shrine music. And, yeah. Oh, second party member. Go quickly grab a third, per se. Yeah, kill these guys in a hit now. Pretty sure you can get Bat Rocks from the Elder ones, which are kind of brown colored. Stand in front. And I will end my. Not my stream, but my recording here after I'm done naming him. I'm not gonna name him Jones, we're gonna name the best name in the world for party members. Because that's been a running gag for god knows how long for me in RPGs. We'll get to the city, then I'll end it. Or not end it, sorry, I'll stop recording and then recording again. Good job, Toast, you defend. So one thing I do like about spells is you can actually target who you want to attack, and it divides them accordingly. So it's half strength right now, and then one third if I were to put a third person on. There we go. So we will quickly stop here, just one sec here.